Everything that you have ever talked bad about, you have wanted at one point or another.
Everybody, welcome back.
Why the fuck did I start it like that?
Everybody, welcome back to another video.
I am your host. Technically, like, for a while I was saying that this is On the Floor with Liliosaurus, and technically I am on the floor and I am Liliosaurus, so I am your host of On the Floor with Liliosaurus. Anyway though, I've had this topic in the back of my brain for weeks on end now, and I think now is just like the time to be talking about it. And basically what I'm trying to get out of here, you're not gonna be happy anywhere. You're really not. You really are not going to be happy anywhere. There's not going to be a certain place that gives you happiness. You're not gonna have happiness if you're with a certain person. You're not gonna have happiness if you have a certain status. You only achieve happiness when you just accept things for how they are. So why I feel called to like do the video now for this week is because yesterday I was watching a Netflix movie. It was called Look Both Ways. I might watch it again, but like, I'm not gonna, it was maybe like 6.5 out of 10. I don't know, it's not anything crazy. Like, it's not a revolutionary movie. It was basically about this girl who hooks up with this guy, and it shows what her life would be like if she got pregnant and then if she didn't get pregnant. And it just goes off and it shows you two different directions. But at the base of it all, one, at the end of the movie, like, yes, she like ends up with two different guys. One, but in the movie was kind of interesting because like she did meet both guys in each scenario. So it's kind of, it's interesting how like our lives will always naturally intertwine no matter what. But at the end of the movie, she basically looks at herself in the mirror and she's like, you're okay, like you're good, like you did it, like you're doing great, you know? First off, I was bawling my eyes out so hard because everybody knows that I struggle with motherhood, right? Like, I feel like my Boston, like New England accent comes out whenever I try to say mother. Motherhood? Motherhood? I don't know. But basically, I used to be very hard on myself about my choice with having my son. And it's not to say that, I don't know, in the movie it talked about how you like, you mourn your sense of self. You mourn your old self. Because she had quoted, and in the movie the character reacted, but like I also reacted the same exact time. I was like, oh my God, because no matter what now, I will never not be somebody's mom. Isn't that so weird? Like I will never, no matter what, I am always gonna be somebody's mom at the end of the day. Ugh. Like, what the fuck? That's so crazy. Ew. It's like, I'm aware of it, but then other times I'm not. Like, I don't know. Maybe this sounds really like bad of me, but sometimes I don't know how to word it properly, but sometimes I feel like I'm not taking care of my own child. Like, I feel like I'm like he's just like my younger, sometimes he just feels like my younger self, and other times he just kind of feels like my younger brother or something. And I know that's not entirely true. Like, trust me, like I do like acknowledge that he is my child. I don't know, I'm not wording this right at all, but like, when do you guys feel like a parent? Like, when do you like, I don't know. Maybe it's just something within me that I have to learn to accept and I have to like understand, but it's just like sometimes like I don't know how to properly word it because I feel like I'm just making myself like look to be like a bad mom. And trust me, I don't need y'all to say that to me because I struggle with that internally every single day. Thank you so much. Whatever, this is not the point of what I'm trying to get at here. The point that I'm trying to get at here is that for a while I have been trying to come to terms with my life for what it is and the present moment for what it is. Because really sometimes a lot of the ups and downs will bring you right back to the same place. Maybe no matter what, some things are just destined in your life to happen. Because in the movie, how I mentioned, she met both guys. She ended up with two different, like she ended up with a different one for each scenario, but like still she kind of like met each one. So it's like that in a way is kind of always destined to happen. You could be destined to be with somebody regardless. You could be destined to move somewhere regardless. You could be destined to experience something regardless of your choices from before. The Midnight Library, that book, also kind of touches with this topic, I think. Not like so much, but in general, there's so many things, there's so many analogies that we all could create, but it's like at the end of the day, we really just have to take the present moment for what it is, and we have to accept our life at face value, and we have to just accept things for how they are and accept things for how they've become. So let me tell you why this whole topic in general has started up, okay? I don't want to get too into it because it's been somewhat resolved, and if they see this, it's no harm done. But at one point, somebody was bringing up to me like, oh, well, you weren't happy when you lived here anyway, and like you weren't happy when you lived here the first time anyway, and all this other stuff, blah, blah, blah. So that's what I'm saying, like, you're not gonna be happy wherever you are unless you decide for yourself in that moment that you're happy. Unless you decide to accept your actions and just be so grateful of where you've gotten. Because first time around, I've lived there before and it was fine. And it really wasn't that bad. And then when I moved back to Massachusetts, I struggled with it a lot and I didn't like living there. And then we moved back. At first I was like struggling again and I didn't like it. And I wasn't happy with the outcome. And it was just a lot of guilt and shame. So really, what is that one song by Lana Del Rey? I don't want to stop recording this because the angle is perfect. Wait, let me go find it.
Is that the song? Sure, you left California, but it's just a state of mind. Turns out everywhere you go,
you take yourself as not a lie. Is that the song? Is it the song? Let me not get obsessed with that lyric now. I love lyrics. I love songs. I love lyrics. I love music. That's why I'm going to be a musician one day. This is just a stepping stone for me. Keep in mind that y'all are watching me and quite literally going to be a recording artist. And you guys are gonna be like, oh my God, like I remember watching her podcast videos, things on YouTube, and now she's like, oh, here, being Baby MILF, doing all these songs. It's like, yeah, I told you bitches. I'm sorry, I cut that in a very, shout out my angels. Anyway, is it California? Let's just have a quick instrumental break. Oh, it's fucking I Love You. Okay, let me not get too into it because I'll get into it. Yeah, that lyric. It turns out everywhere you go, you take yourself, that's not a lie. And so that's basically like what it all is that like, you can change your scenery, you can change like the background, but if you don't change your sense of self, if you don't change your mind, then you're never going to feel fulfilled and you're never going to feel at peace with where you are. You're always going to constantly be wishing for more. The whole sentiment of the grass is greener where you water it is true. And you shouldn't be watering somebody else's garden, because when you take the time to fulfill your dreams and your goals, like it just kind of proves what the theory of, is that law of attraction? It might be law of not attraction, but like the other one, the one that's like assumption. Yeah, law, I think it's more so law of assumption, where it's like whatever is for me won't miss me, because whatever is for you will present itself to you no matter how long it took to get there. So I'm also kind of talking to myself as I say this, and it's just like so crazy to me, because I genuinely feel like this is gonna be the year where I get everything I want. Like I need to stop worrying. Like this is the year where everything goes right for me, and since everything's gonna go right for me, everything's gonna go right for you. I genuinely want to help so many of you guys. I want to help so many people. So it's like, now that I've finally been pouring into my own cup and doing everything that I need to do, oh, we can all rejoice and we can all just be so happy, because like everything is just going to start being so much better. And it's all because like, it's just like a mindset shift. It really is. Like it sounds so silly when you're not in it and when you don't have that kind of like strength and power over yourself, but when you do have that, a good mindset shift makes everything just so much easier to find the goodness in things. That's why it's better to pour into your own cup first. Just like how they say on an airplane, put on your oxygen mask first, because the right things will always be the right thing for you. You might have had to learn hard lessons, but when you take those lessons and you give them, I don't want to say like give them a reason, because obviously there are some really dark twisted things. Like trust me, like there is so much that I don't think I'm like discrediting for myself, but so much that I am quote unquote choosing to let go of, because it just doesn't serve me anymore. Like holding on to the baggage does not serve me. Holding on to the anger does not serve me. It does nothing for me. all I can do is proceed to go forward. That's why I think my video, where it says it's time to let go, your old life doesn't serve you anymore, has as many views as it does, because like, it's true. And I'm so glad that it got the reach that it did. And I'm glad that it's like helped people. And I'm glad that through that video, so many people have now found me and are watching me, because just that whole mindset in itself, like, really changed my perspective on a lot of things. And that's why I'm coming here to tell you that, like, you can definitely outgrow places. I've learned that I've outgrown the city that I'm in now, just because it's not really like made for people who are in their upper 20s. There's not shit to do. There really isn't. But you can find things to make things better. I do try to appreciate the value that I can go outside for walks and runs, and I am in a place of access to go to restaurants and like coffee shops and all this other stuff. But overall, just not really providing me with, it's not taking me where I want to go, but I can still find the value in it and I can still be appreciative of it. That's why, like, just how they say, like, to tend to your own garden and to water your own grass. But that doesn't mean that I'm going to move somewhere and it's automatically going to be better. Because if I go there and if I don't fulfill a certain happiness within myself first, I'm always going to find out things that I dislike about it, and I'm always going to keep wishing that I had what I had in the past. And dang, the more that I talk, the more that I genuinely think that this is like one of my overall lessons. Cause I wish so badly I could tell you what's going on right now, but I can't, cause I don't wanna look like a fool. It's kind of funny I said fool. Anyway, obviously though, regardless, like I said, if it's for me, it will always be for me. If it's not for me, it'll go and that'll be it. And I'll be fine. Because I've learned how to give myself that love. I've learned how to fulfill certain needs within myself. I've learned how to give myself grace. I've learned how to accept parts of myself that some people might not like. I might have to go back living with my family for a little bit. And is it nerve-wracking? Yes, of course. But instead of trying to see the bad in it and just viewing it as something that I don't want to do, I can instead try to just take the opportunity as it comes at face value and be really grateful for all the opportunities and experiences that I'll be able to have and I'll be able to get. Because one, first off, with what I'm trying to do, like being on YouTube, TikTok, make music, write, all the other stuff, I can take that with me wherever I go. I'm very, like, it's definitely a blessed thing that I want to set my foot into, where like, it doesn't matter too much actual location. Like, of course, yeah, I'd probably get more opportunities and I'd be able to have more content and more just exciting things to film if I was in a bigger city with just so many different options. But overall, you can film wherever. So it's like, even in general, like if you've been wanting to start doing something like this, like start a YouTube, start podcasting, start blogging, start just posting on social media, just go ahead and do it, because you will find a community who wants to uplift you. And I genuinely think that we are seeing more of that in general. I think that we're starting to see more of a community-based following, and that we're seeing less celebrity-focused culture. One, that's just happening naturally astrologically, so it's like, duh. But two, like, it's very interesting to actually see it be played out. With all this being said, if you're not happy with where you are, you can go ahead and change the circumstances if you want, but it's never going to get better unless you change the way that you view the world and the way that you view things and the way that you accept your life for what it is. I could sit here and I could be upset with the choices that I've made. I could be feeling discouraged that I don't entirely have the freedom to just pack things up and move all around the world how I used to. Or instead, I could view it as, okay, because the thing that I just thought of was that I was talking with my friend, and honestly, I think that I was going to be a mom within that time frame regardless, because it was just so heavy on my mind. Like, it was just, it was insane. Like, I wanted to, that was what I wanted to do next. And maybe sometimes there's certain stepping stones that our body has to have us go through regardless, so that we can get to the main goal. because whether it is becoming a mom or whether it's, say, you're working at a company, it's not a place that you want to be working after the rest of your life, but it's like that company is the stepping stone that is going to take you to either make your own business or to your dream job that you've always wanted to land, you know? Because it's all about the small experiences, the small like things that you can add up that make it all like who we are. And so when I accepted that, it made it a little bit easier because like I realized that the outcome of it all really isn't so bad. I can sit here and I can complain about certain circumstances, and trust me, it's not always the greatest. I'm not gonna lie about that here. I'm not trying to hurt anybody's feelings with that, but it's like, it might not be the greatest thing in the world, but, and I understand that sometimes it might even get harder, but the overall aspect is that it's really just like the butterfly effect too. Like just everything had to happen in order to get to this present moment sometimes. And it's, I don't know a better way to describe it. Even if only one person is watching this, I'm probably helping that one person out. Fine with me, because one, it's good for me to get all these thoughts out, and it's showing the universe that I do want to take this seriously. Oh, I remember now. I remember a very important thing that I wanted to say. I wanted to say that at one point, everything that you have ever talked bad about, you have wanted at one point or another. Yeah. Yeah. Everything that you turn around and you, let me use myself for example. I once wanted this apartment so badly. And there's been times where I've complained about it. And there's been times where I've complained about living in the city again. There was a point where all I wanted was to move out of my home in Massachusetts and start a life and do what I needed to do. And I did that. There was a point where I wanted to live in this apartment building so badly, and I did that. And even just something as small as like, maybe you really wanted to go on a date with that guy, and then it turns out that you weren't a match, or like maybe you really wanted to be friends with this one person, and then it turns out that she talked behind your back. There was a point where you wanted that so badly. So you kind of have to honor that and accept it, because at the end of the day, like you did get what you want. It just might not exactly be what you need at the time. When you put yourself in a mindset like that, it can just kind of help accept things for what they are, I suppose. But it also just, I don't know, like makes, what the freak? Excuse me, I'm trying to talk here. But it also just makes things a lot better on you mentally. Maybe you hate your job now, but it's like, you really wanted a job at one point. You wanted to work there so badly at one point. So if you're always viewing things in this very negative way, or just kind of like, oh, like a certain disdain for stuff, you need to remind yourself that everything you have, you desperately wanted at some point, and you can desperately want more. And again, maybe you'll get a chance to go on a trip somewhere that you really always wanted to go, and then it turns out that you didn't actually have fun on your trip. But it's like, there is a version of you who was so excited to hear that they're going to a certain place or a certain country, and they could not be more ecstatic about it. So you have to honor, accept that, because if not, then you're kind of like, you're disqualifying yourself, and you're kind of like being mean to your past self in a way. It's almost as if you were going back to yourself as a little kid and being like, yeah, we did become an artist, but it turns out everybody hated our paintings, and that's not really what we do now, like blah blah blah. You know what I mean? Like, don't you think that your younger self would be kind of sad, when instead you could view it as, oh, we did become an artist, we tried it out, it was okay, but through art we learned that our real passion is photography, and now we're a big photographer, and we've worked with this person, and we've helped model campaigns for this magazine or this company, like stuff like that. You get what I'm saying? This is just like a little bit of my own knowledge, my own self-encouragement that I wanted to add on for the day. But at the end of it all, water your own grass, tend to your own garden, and the flowers look better where you planted them, where you took care of them. Don't look at anybody else's flowers. Don't look at anybody else's life. Don't look at anybody else's anything. Because I hate to sound corny, but like, yeah, like everybody is on their own path for a reason. And when you sit there and you compare other people, you're just taking away from your own success, taking you away from your own happiness, because you're just sitting there, you're comparing. And comparison is one of the worst things that you could do. I've always said comparison is the biggest form of self-hate. Because why are you comparing yourself to somebody else? You don't know how long it took them to get there. You could have started at 18 years old, now you're in the same boat, or they could have started at 8 years old and failed. And either way, regardless, you guys are on the same boat. So it's like, you're both in that same present moment, either which way. So just take it as what it is. Maybe they learned easier lessons than you. Maybe they learned harder lessons than you. You don't know what somebody's gone through. So as long as you just try to be happy and grateful for where you are at now and what you've got now, you are able to find true happiness wherever. And it won't matter if you're living in New York or you're living in Houston or you're living in the Midwest, if you feel called, if you feel like you need to be living out of the country. The outside circumstances won't matter because you will be happy with where you are either way. That's all I've got today. But overall, as long as you just keep focusing on what's going to make you into the best version of yourself, it shouldn't matter where you live. Because one, social media is so fake, okay? You could be watching somebody who lives in New York post about living there, but you don't know if they're actually broke. You don't know if they're actually in so much debt. You don't know if they actually hate their job. You don't know if they're actually so miserable living there, because we're all just seeing, quite literally how they say, a highlight reel of everybody's lives. They can be posting that they're having such a great time, but it's like, actually, maybe they want to trade places with you. Maybe they want to go back to the suburbs and live in 9-to-5 and they want to feel happy just like that. You never know how someone is truly feeling. Other than that, I love you all so much. Thank you all so much for watching my video. And let me know some other topics you might want me to touch upon. I just really needed to talk about this. I've been feeling really called to just kind of make a quick video. And again, I appreciate you all. I will see you all in my next video. Bye guys.